Cologne is the area where I grew up. And then I moved in 2004 to Australia and I was looking for a job there and happened to come across this startup called Atlassian. We had 12 people back then and turned out that was a good choice. I spent the next 15 years at Atlassian and left in 2019. This year, I started my own company back in the Atlassian ecosystem. The company is called Released. And with Released, we help our customers create just stunning release notes straight from their Jira tickets. And you're going to see a demo at the end and how that works. And as I mentioned, I spent 15 years at Atlassian. I want to start with a short story from my time there. In 2012, I had the opportunity to be part of a pretty exciting project at Atlassian. We started the development of a brand new product, a venture that marked the first in-house creation since Confluence in Jira. And with a team of around 15 people, we developed the first version of the product in a bit more than 6 months. And we released it in May 2012. And that product was Bitbucket Server. Now, there was another product in the market called GitHub Enterprise. And probably if you technically, you heard about GitHub. Back then, GitHub Enterprise was around for 3 years already. And here we come into the market 6 months in, first version or first release, delivering the bare minimum that you would expect from a Git hosting solution. So the question for us was, how do we convince people to even consider Bitbucket? We don't have all the features that GitHub has. And of course, there was the recent Atlassian integration, and we gave companies like a couple of reasons. But one key thing that we needed to do was give our customers confidence in our ability to deliver more and more capabilities as they grow with the product. So as their requirements grow, their needs grow, that we can deliver that. And we needed to prove that to them pretty quickly. So we did two things. We actually did a combination of fast iterations and great customer communication. With the fast iterations, we introduced 5-week release cycles. Today, that like you release all the time to the cloud, so that doesn't seem as fast. But back then, our standard release cycle for Confluence in Jira was actually 90 days, so three months instead of 5 weeks. So that's the first thing. We wanted to ship features faster to our customers. But the second part was to listening to the feedback and communicating changes that we make to the product and get them excited with every single release that we put out there. And it was really important to us. And we know that it worked because more than 80% of the customers that we had back then upgraded every 5 weeks to the latest release. And that was before updates happened automatically in the cloud as well. So really, release notes are extremely valuable. That was like one of the key lessons. And this is just one anecdote that demonstrates how important customer communication is in general. But let's take a step back and look at some of the kind of important benefits that people don't really consider when they think about release notes. Let's start with the first one, increased conversion. Like, how do release notes increase conversion? Think about when you come to a website and there's a what's new section. Click on the what's new section, and then you see that the company ships feature after feature that gets you excited to read it. Compared to not having that section at all, or compared to coming, and I'll show you that later, coming to a page that doesn't have many updates. It's an opportunity for you to demonstrate to your customers that, again, you are committed to improving the product and meeting their needs, even if the feature that they might require is not there yet, but they know that something will come in the future. So that's how you increase conversion. The second one is more obvious, increase loyalty and retention by getting people excited about the things you ship, letting them know about capabilities that you ship. And that's really important. I talked to a product manager at Canva, and they get sometimes requests for features that have been released a year ago, but customers just don't find out about it because the product is pretty complex by now. Some smaller features are a bit more hidden. So you got to make sure that you communicate features to your customers efficiently and get them excited about it. And then lastly, is release notes are a good opportunity to cross-sell and upsell your customers as well. There might be features available in the premium tier that they don't have right now, but you can advertise them in those release notes or advertise capabilities that they gain when they integrate with other tools in their portfolio. But it's not just the external and commercial benefits there. There's also internal benefits for communication, of course. First of all, for release notes in general, it aligns all the go-to-market teams. From the marketing team, first of all, make sure that you even craft the release notes together with them to make sure that you have the same message. Then the sales team needs to know what's going out. So they can go to their prospects and let them know that the features that maybe they were holding out for is coming now and they can go and purchase the product. And the support team as well, they need to understand what features they have to support in the next few weeks and ask questions about it and have a readiness meeting. The other part is particular company like Atlassian, I think that was really important. You also, in order to be successful, you don't need to just market outside. You also need to market internally the product and the projects to get support from the leadership team. And the more you get people excited about a product, the more you get support, of course. And you don't do that with just general project updates, so the timeline and are we finishing this and pretty like boring updates. You want to get them just as excited like you want to get your external customers excited. And then lastly, it's about cross-team enablement or alignment. If you have a platform team, for example, that ships capabilities to other teams that rely on it, release notes are a great way for them to communicate the changes that they've been making and that they're available now. And other teams can subscribe to those updates, subscribe to different parts of those updates that they're interested in and get notified when new features or capabilities become available. But the challenge is most people don't do release notes well, and customers often have been conditioned not to read them in the first place because they're often too technical for customers. They aren't helpful. They can be too long. They can be boring. Sometimes they try to be funny, and that's not always a good thing. And let's have a look at a few ways that you should not write your updates. First one is this one. That's an example from the App Store. Version history, bug fixes, stability improvements, repairs to the space-time continuum. And that might be funny once, but not every week. And also, it's not very helpful information. And that's part of the reason why people don't go to the App Store anymore to read release notes. And to be fair, it's not the best and most obvious place where you should publish them. So in the app is probably better. But then if you have an app or even like something like there's not a Kindle, there's something else, but this team had clearly an opportunity to communicate with their customers and tell them something important, get them excited about the product, get them excited about the changes that they're making. And they really missed that opportunity here. So if you think about it, customers or companies spend $600 billion on digital marketing every year to reach consumers, to reach customers and talk to them. And then when they have a customer and have the opportunity to talk to them, they don't really use it. So think about all the touch points that you have with your customers that you could improve. Another one is if you don't invest time in writing release notes, you can't really expect others to invest time in reading them. And we've seen this, I've seen this in the plenty of release notes where people just dump a Jira issue macro onto Confluence page to communicate the updates. And clearly there was no thought and time invested in here. It might be in maybe some people find it okay and they read it, but for the majority of people, it's just not very helpful. The summary often doesn't say much. There's a lot of information that's not needed. Just, you can do better. You can do better. And the last one is the example that I mentioned earlier. This is actually from another release notes app that I evaluated 2 years ago, I think. And you can see the update here is Twitter integration updates on June 14th, Twitter integration fix on February 23rd, and then the previous feature was actually in May 20. And that was exactly the reason why I didn't go ahead and purchase that product, because I knew that if there was anything I need, I probably would not get it. So conversion, like they didn't convert me. What do good release notes look like? Starting with Microsoft Teams, they do a pretty good job writing their release notes. This is a great example of keeping it short, clear and descriptive titles, explain what the benefits are to the user, and short description adds just the right amount of detail. They also add links to the documentation or more detailed posts about specific capabilities and some images as well. This is a solid, simple example. Another one I really like is a product called Raycast that's available for macOS. And with each announcement, Raycast highlights one or two major features at the top. It's much more like marketing focused. Beautiful images and text that's pretty clear with links as well to more detail. And further down, they have a new section and bug fixes as well that are more technical and more concise in format. It's more like informational that you just read quickly. Another thing that's noteworthy here though is they also advertise a waitlist that they currently have for the AI features or a link to a video. So promoting capabilities that are coming up and getting people excited about it. Again, let's consider this a customer touch point and a marketing opportunity. And then lastly, just because they do a couple of neat things with the UI elements, is Sketch, which is a design tool. So it's pretty important that the changelog looks its part in terms of design. And here you can see that they actually have a lozenge at the top that tells us how many new items are in this release, how many posts have we missed. So when we scroll down, we know exactly there's like a bunch of things that I missed since last time I came here. So that was really neat. And then the obvious kind of categories, Mac or web, so you can filter down what you're interested in. But these ones are really done well as well. So why doesn't everyone just do this? Doesn't seem so hard, is it? Well, it's actually quite difficult to write good release notes. It starts with gathering changes. You have to talk to the engineering team to figure out what has shipped. There's a lot of back and forth. When I talked to customers, that was always one of the problems, and you don't want to interrupt the engineering team too much, distracts them as well. Then the writing part is also not easy. Unless you're a technical writer, writing might not come easy to everyone, and writing good and consistent copy is a hard thing to do. Publishing release notes, making it look good, making it, it has to go on your website, it has to go into your product, and you want to make sure that looks nice as well. Which brings me to discoverability. The App Store is probably not the best way to publish the release notes. The website is a good one for conversion, but in order to reach your existing users, it's often best to put it into the product. And that's, again, like a challenge to do that. You need an engineering team to do it, to help with that. And then lastly, it's consistency. You want to do release notes every week or every month, like whatever your cadence is, but you want to make sure that gets consistently done. And that's also tricky. So release notes, writing release notes is usually looks like this today. This is actually an app that a release notes app that helps you write release notes. It helps publishing release notes. That's fine. They do a decent job at it. But what they don't do is help me write it. And that was the biggest issue that I faced in my last role after I left Atlassian, because I had to write the release notes. And I just wanted a product that was easier to use. So I wrote the first prototype of what we have today back then to integrate with Jira. And I wanted to use that information that I already have there and not duplicate at all. And that's how we arrived at released. So with released, we really wanted to build a product that is, first of all, easy to use. Everybody should be able to publish a great looking release note in less than 15 minutes. We wanted it to integrate with the information that we already had in Jira and enabling better collaboration with the engineering team and the product managers and the marketing team. And then lastly, there are a lot of tasks that are just like tedious to do, and we wanted to automate a lot more, make it a more seamless and frictionless experience. And that's how we arrived at released. And I would love to show you a quick demo of what that actually looks like. So this is Jira, as you can tell. And once you install the released app in Jira, you get a link here on the left-hand side. So when you click this, you come to the released section of Jira. And the first thing that you will notice is that you see all the release notes from this project. So you can scroll down and see what happened in this project, which is already a great start for internal communication. Everybody can go to a certain project, go to the release notes to see what has this team shipped. So that's the first thing. And then the second part is to create a release note. You can create post. And here you have the option to choose between done since, give me everything that has been done since a certain date, or with a fixed version as well. In this case, we stick with done since. And there's a convenient shortcut here that it shows us everything that's been done since the last announcement, which was July 12th. Or you can pick a time frame, 1 week, 2 weeks, a month, and then if you feel like it, you can further filter the tickets available. For example, if your team labels everything that's important for release notes with like public note or some sort of label, you can filter all those items ahead of time. But we're going to just go ahead and click on get started. And then we'll see a couple of things here. On the left-hand side is our editor, super clean, super easy to use. We have a slash command here, similar to Confluence, that allows us to add headings, images, bullet lists, anything that we want to do to format the release notes. And then on the right-hand side, we have what we call the staging area. And this is where all the tickets that have been done since the last release or are currently in progress, because we know they're going to be completed, are displayed. So you can click on those items. You get a preview of those tasks. And here's the description. And now we want to turn them into release notes. And the way we do this is pretty simple. So you just select an item. So we have this ticket selected. There's a generate button at the bottom. You click this button and then we start generating that public description for you.
Right.
So this is complete now. You can see the ticket has changed now. It looks a little bit different. And then all we need to do is just drag and drop this over. And here we have this public description. So we've added a new feature that allows us to attach files or images directly to tasks. You see how it's different. It's like a tone is externally focused rather than internal instructions. And that's basically how we do this. So let's say this is just the core feature that we wanted to add. And then we'll have some bugs here as well. Bugs. We'll go to our bug section here. We'll take these three, generate description here. We want to display them in a shorter format and bullet lists. And we'll just go and drag them over. And then we have the description for the bugs as well. And we'll add more capabilities to customize the prompts and make this shorter. That's just one sentence, but it gives you a really good starting point to then just cut it down and make it shorter to start with. Last thing that we might want to do is add a title, new release. We can add a cover image as well. Let's pick one here. We can crop this nicely. Now it spends a little bit of time uploading. And once we're done here, we can basically go ahead and publish our release notes. And there's two options to publish. One is in the announcement page. That's typically a page that's on your website. And the second one is an embedded widget. I'll show you in a second what those look like. And you can choose to publish to one or the other. For example, if you have an embedded widget in an app, and you just want to announce something to your customers, you can just publish something to there and potentially customers coming to your website, they won't see that announcement. So now this is available here. And there's a couple of ways to embed this. If we go to settings here, we see the widget and the announcement page. You get a preview of what it looks like. There's already a one that indicates that there's a new post that we just made. We click on it. So this is what the widget looks like that you can embed into your app. Get the details. So it's just beautiful resizes and can be customized in terms of colors as well. And the text in there and the announcement page similar has the image there and the description, everything. And that's basically, it's super simple. And that's the whole point. We wanted to keep it really, really simple. The way to install it is just a couple script tags that you can embed into your website or your app. And that's all that's required. Just release notes. Super simple. How you can get it, it's on the Atlassian marketplace. If you just go to marketplace.atlassian.com, you search for released or release notes, you will see that logo of ours pop up in the first spot there. And that's basically it with the presentation. Thank you for listening.